Good morning class. So I would like to continue with what I was doing. That is, we were marking maps and plateaus and passes. So here we go again. So again, coming back to the same map. Now we begin with the mountains in the south, and we have already marked the Vindhya mountains. And for that, I want you to remember a few things. You can see that to the south of the Vindhya lies the Narmada river, so the mountain Vindhya should not touch the river Narmada, and the rivers above also should not touch the Vindhya mountain. So that particular line that we are using to mark Vindhya should be set in such a way that it doesn't touch the lines above and below. Now moving further on, I'm going to mark the Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats. And so for that, you can see here that we have a arrow, we have a line very close to the coast. It's a brown colored line and it's a vertical line showing the Western Ghats. And on the eastern side, you have two lines, one between the river Mahanadi and Godavari, and the other between the Krishna and the Kaveri rivers. These are the Eastern Ghats. Now notice that the Western Ghats, which lie on the west, they are a series of continuous hills, and the Eastern Ghats are discontinuous. The Western Ghats are very close to the coast, and the Eastern Ghats are slightly away from the coast. So these are Eastern Ghats here, as you can see. And let me also mark the rivers, which will make this very clear. Yes, so this is river Mahanadi, and this river here, which I'm marking now, is river Godavari, and this river here is river Krishna, and the southernmost river is Kaveri. So the Eastern Ghats, they lie between the river Mahanadi and Godavari, and between river Krishna and river Kaveri. Okay, moving further on, to mark the plateaus, you can see a small brown colored circle, which I'm pointing with the blue arrow here. This circle here is the Chota Nagpur Plateau, and it lies to the south of River Damodar. Let me mark it again because it came out to be a very big line. Okay, this short line here, this green colored line here, this is river Damodar, and to the south of this river lies the Chota Nagpur Plateau, which is rich in minerals. It is rich in coal and iron ore, and hence all the iron and steel industry is located here. Then between the Vindhya Mountains, the Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats lies the, you see this area here, this is the Deccan Plateau. So when we mark Deccan Plateau, we have to first mark these mountains. And one very important thing which I forgot to mention, children, I forgot to mention the Nilgiri Hills. So you can see there's a small dash here, brown color dash, to the south of River Kaveri. Now this is River Kaveri, and to the south of River Kaveri, there is a small dash, brown colored line here. This is the Nilgiri Hills. Nil means blue, Giri means mountain. So Nilgiris are the blue mountains, and they are very important because they are the meeting place of Western Ghats and the eastern ghats. That's where the western ghats and the eastern ghats end. So you will notice that beyond Nilgiris, there are no western ghats and eastern ghats. And Nilgiris lie to the south of river Kaveri. So with this, we come to the end of this session. Thank you.